Hello, my name is John Chow. I work for PUFsecurity. And today I will be talking about how to solve chip security's weakest link, an insecure key storage, with a PUF-based hardware root of trust, establishing a complete secure boundary. First, let me briefly introduce myself and our company. So PUFsecurity is an eMemory subsidiary dedicated to researching and developing integrated security IPs. As you can tell from our name, we are focused on PUF-based solutions. I work primarily in business development and technical marketing, and I'm excited to share our approach to solving the issues around key security in hardware. Today, the threats we face from hacking have become commonplace. Whether it's hacking from a vehicle, hacking from a small IoT device, where instructions can be easily found on YouTube, or hacking from the supply chain, it is already compromising our privacy and hurting our finances, not to mention the potential threat to life. That's why people are more and more aware of the importance of having security in their systems or devices. Traditionally, we try to use software security to fix the problem, but hackers are getting better at identifying weaknesses in a system. So today, hardware and software security are both equally important. While software security can be updated after production, hardware security cannot. Therefore, it is crucial to implement the correct and most reliable hardware security right from the beginning. Hackers always find the weakest link to penetrate, and usually, insecure key storage using the eFuse is a common weakness. The consequence can be an entire system being compromised, which potentially can be very costly. In a hardware security subsystem, both hard IP and soft IP are required. This is something that's not often fully appreciated. Soft IP includes what common security IP vendors provide, such as a secure CPU and crypto algorithms, such as AES, hash, and ECC. The hard IP, on the other hand, which is process dependent, includes secure storage, root key generation, both static and dynamic entropy, as well as anti-tampering. A hard macro that combines all these primitives will be the ideal hardware root of trust. And with a secure controller, it'll be a drop-in design to any security subsystem or crypto engine. In the next section, I'd like to go into more detail on these three fundamentals of hardware root of trust, which again are the secure key storage, root key generation, and high-quality entropy. The eFuse, or electric fuse, and anti-fuse OTP memory are the most common options for key storage in modern chip design. With eFuse, the key is programmed into OTP memory by blowing a portion of metal or poly, which leaves a visible trace. Meanwhile, the anti-fuse OTP is programmed based on the oxide burnout mechanism. The burnout creates a conductive path without a visible trace on the surface. By looking at the SCM's top view comparison between eFuse and anti-fuse OTP after being programmed, the 0 and 1 data stored in the eFuse are easily recognizable, as there is a clear opening in the cell program to 1. Compare this to the anti-fuse OTP cell. They look the same regardless of the data stored. A secure OTP can use PUF to further protect the data by shuffling the physical address of each chip, unlike an anti-fuse OTP, which has a fixed address. This can prepare a device for any new attack methods or technologies that might occur in the future. Next, I would like to talk about generating your root key or static entropy. The conventional method is external key injection, which must be done during CP or FT stage, with a clean room, key management server, and all these other resources and equipment. This will have an extra cost of around $0.5 to $2 per device. You can see from this comparison, by using the decentralized identification of PUF on the right side, for both hardware unique key, greatly simplifies the process and allows key provisioning to be done either in field or at the CPFT stage. This reduces costs and enhances the security level with zero touch provisioning. Of course, a random and reliable PUF, such as the quantum tunneling NeoPUF shown here, is also very important. An ideal PUF should have perfect randomness, perfect uniqueness, 0% bit error rate, no pre or post processing required, no helper data required. It should also be untraceable, red hard, with 100% manufacturability in all technologies. Lastly, is creating a high quality dynamic entropy source. Usually, soft IP vendors require the customer or user to integrate their own dynamic entropy source. The PUF-based TRNG, from a theoretical point of view, is very much like using PUF for a runtime hash function. The effective entropy comes from dynamic entropy by ring oscillators, and the 1K-bit PUF secret is used for post-processing. And this hash behavior is different from each restart from chip to chip. This is a very interesting and unique invention, and the outcome is a very high quality and high performance PUF-based TRNG. Therefore, a PUF-based hardware root of trust starts with a unified hard macro. It begins by combining static entropy from PUF and dynamic entropy from a source such as ring oscillators. The PUF can be used to refine the dynamic entropy for high quality and high performance PUF-based TRNG. And finally, combining these entropies with a PUF-based secure OTP that scrambles the OTP with the PUF for extra protection. Generally, other security solutions will not be able to provide an integrated solution with all three primitives. This hard macro combined with soft macro will give the users the most complete and easy to use hardware root of trust. This diagram is a representation of the architecture of PUFsecurity's PUFrt IP. As you can see here, this is a more detailed block diagram of the PUFrt. The PUFrt combines a secure OTP, integrated TRNG, inborn PUF, complete anti-tampering certified by RiskCure, and a dual APB interface with APB1 connected to the main bus for testing and privilege access, and APB2 connected to the crypto engine to protect the secure operation and complete the secure boundary. When it comes to chip security, designers often turn to crypto subsystem solutions like the ARM crypto cell 312. The remaining obstacle, however, is how to generate and safely store the root key for the system. The dual APB PUFrt is the missing piece from the puzzle, with the inborn chip fingerprint from the PUF that acts as a secret key to encrypt anything stored. The equipped anti-tamper cell makes it more resilient against potential attacks. With its well-planned architecture, PUFrt can be easily dropped into replace eFuse while saving engineering effort, as the controller is included. The combined solution not only completes secure boundary for IC, but also maximizes the effectiveness of CC312 or any other crypto engines for the entire SoC's performance. Thank you, and that will be all I have for today. If you have any further questions or comments, please don't hesitate to email us, visit our website, or even add me on LinkedIn. Be safe and have a nice day.